expecting James Bond thriller out of this speech, then kindly say that you will be disappointed. What you will not be disappointed from this speech is the approach it takes to solve the problem in question. So what is the problem in question? I talked 2 weeks back. Okay. The problem is procrastination. I always find it funny that probably the word also was invented to overcome some of it. So difficult. So coming to the history part, right? We always tend to feel that we are a clever lot. Yet the magnificent and mighty brains we have are also with which we have touched the moon, split the atom, etc., are also the same stupid brains that don't let us start preparing for the speech till the day before it is due. So it's we have evolved from primitive creatures, but don't tend to shed off their legacy. We all recognize that conscious thinking part of our brain, which we tend to call conscience. Let's call him the amazingly awesome Albert. Alongside him stays another impulsive baby reptile in your head. Let's call him the rarely rationalistic Rex. So now, we all like to think ourselves as Albert, because he's the thinking, rational, perfect kind of human being. When you made that decision to go to the gym or wake up early in the morning, it was Albert who made the decision. But unlike Albert, Rex evolved in primitive creatures, millions of years ago. So unsurprisingly, his instincts are primitive. They are without language. For example, hunger, love, fear, etc. are the emotions which are the expressions of Rex. Here is one thing that you will never like to listen. It is Rex who makes the final decision in all your, the final call in all your decisions. It is not that bad because Rex does listen to Albert sometimes. But if Rex wants to crash on the sofa, eat a pizza and watch Harry Potter, that's what you're going to do. So the incredible development we see all around ourselves, which we call as civilization, is mainly because we have developed systems which subdue, subvert and soothe this baby reptile in ourselves. So the main question: why do we procrastinate? If you think of this as a similar situation, it would be a young adult trying to convince a child to constantly do something that he wants. The child does as long as he wants to do it, but once he doesn't want to do it, he'll never listen. Same is the case with the Albert Rex. Whenever Rex wants to do something, and Albert asks him to do, he does it. But otherwise, he's going to wail and scream. So how do you get past this? It's important to learn that you need to cajole Rex to do what you want to do. There are some rules to do it. Like, first of all, realize that logic is not going to work with Rex. It's emotions which are going to work with Rex. You need to either excite him or you need to terrify him. As primitive as Rex is, language and logic cannot convince him. The second point would be, comfort matters. Now, if you are feeling tired, hungry, or you are depressed, your baby reptile will never allow you to do a single damn thing you ask it to. Realize that all it wants to do is have fun, sleep, and have fun. Third point would be to nurture discipline. You need to maintain you need to maintain some positive and negative reinforcements in your like assured punishments for failing through something, or giving yourself personal rewards for achieving something. A typical example of this would be to commit to a public goal or work in a team, because social pressure is what acts. And the most important part is to force a start. One of the characteristics of Rex would be to oppose change. But once you start doing something, this feature will start acting in your favor. Remember, when you were told to go to school, when you were forced to go to school or forced to go to some music classes, that this was the reason behind it. So, one should realize that it's not difficult to overcome procrastination, but it's important to realize the rules with which your brain operates. It's important to realize that you have a baby reptile in your head, and fortunately or unfortunately, it has the driving wheel. It listens to you if you carefully control it, but always remember who is in control, because with procrastination, it is the tomorrow never dies, but in this process, it is the today that is.